as I stated before, by creating these massive impulses, and I demonstrated before everyone, I awakened reflexes. And now look, one, two, three, and previously I did, you remember briefly, I would repeat what I did, like this, hands after hand, all these wonderful techniques, and already we start stimulating central nervous system, upper and in level motor centers, in the lower level motor centers, and little by little, when come to the petrosage, it is already, and you see one, two, three, four, and when I will repeatedly, in this kind of taking time, already when it come to petrosage number one and two, I deeply and deeply moving, and actually peristeum, deeper cannot be. I perform a very deep tissue massage by awakening reflexes, by understanding, gradually increasing pressure, digging in, digging in, digging in, digging in, digging in. This is the one of most important techniques. Now, if your client's bigger in size than you, yeah, you can utilize in the kind of petrosage number five with elbow mobilization, number six, fist. I will demonstrate all these techniques in cases if somebody would love to feel stronger with no trauma. We can actually compromise with them to perform and to provide them with stronger feelings and not to traumatize. In our case, we should not traumatize. First strategy is to awake these reflexes that allowed muscles layer by layer will relax and will allow tension and fascia will be reduced with every hour movement of mobilization and will allow us to go deeper and deeper and deeper. This is kind of one strategy. The second strategy is to shift tissue. An example right now I will demonstrate in cases of piriformis muscles syndrome, that in most cases awakening sciatic and nerve neuralgia, I will right now will a little bit briefly will come to this point, and I will show you the sometimes it's just necessary to use this strategy to shift the tissue, the superficial layers, in order to be able to mobilize deep tissue. In cases of sciatica nerve neuralgia due to a piriformis muscle syndrome, when come to mobilization of piriformis, and piriformis originate from anterior part of sacrum and insert into greater trochanter area and covered actually by glutes. Here, in order to perform deep tissue massage, we have to shift. You see what I'm doing? I'm shifting, and right now here we're utilizing, because of bigger mass here, but first of all, you see, if I will compress, I will transmit some pressure to the piriformis muscles. Very little mobilization will be, but the other strategy is to shift the tissue upwards, and here you can see I will put even elbow, and I do recommend to utilize elbow for stimulation. We know the topographically how this perform is located, and little by little we will do with elbow mobilization and compression even from this, but this will be due to our capability to shift the superficial to go. This is the other strategy for deep tissue massage. And When we're treating thoracic outlet syndrome, and in the main cause of all this neurological picture and all this edemas and the change of colors is overtense anterior scalene muscles. Now, anterior scalene muscles is considered to be deep muscles and covered by sternocleidomastoid muscles, and in such a case, we just have to shift. We have to shift sternocleidomastoid. I usually do this with thumb, but for camera and better vision, you can do with fingers also. You kind of shifting, you see, and here you come to the deeper tissue, which is anterior scalene. Here, so you have to shift, and of course, stimulate shift and stimulate. By the way, as you know, sciatic and nerve neuralgia, thoracic outlet syndrome, anterior scalene muscle syndrome, thoracic outlet syndrome is the most difficult pathology to treat. And in most cases, doctor performing surgeries. From my experience, I know if we will do the right protocol, if we will do and we will follow the protocol, we can reach results in very fast. The other strategies that we using for deep tissue mobilization is a transmission. How much we will mobilize, will shift. Not always we can reach the deeper layers that have to be stimulated. And therefore we use techniques of transmission, compression. Actually, from perspective of physiological effect, this is kind of double benefits. And one of the techniques which we utilizing to break down scar tissue, all this, you see, if they're chronic long time tension in fascia will be, it's adhesive phenomenon. To break down all this stuff, we utilizing like stretch first of all, you go with knuckles, and again, in post-event sport massage, it's massive. This is the most deep tissue techniques that could be. And you stay like gradually increasing pressure, 10-15 seconds, and again, and this is called transmission of pressure. Now, all organic and inorganic material carry piezoelectrical potential, and when we providing this compression, we also awakening stream potential, stream of piezoelectricity that also stimulating inner organs, and of course inner organs reporting this generation of this afferent impulse will reach centers, and this is kind of additional effort of stimulation, massive stimulation, flow to move the chi, flow. And strategy number four is for deep tissue massage is stretching, to perform massage under stretching. Great classic example, it could be any muscle group, but the special, I would pay your attention on masticatory muscles, on chewing muscles responsible for stabilization and movement of TMJ. As you know, TMJ is a problem. A lot of people suffering seriously from headaches, pain in neck, myofascial relations, kind of satellite trigger points development. It is related to myofascial dysfunction, and stretching sometimes is necessary in order to perform a deep tissue massage. And great example again is masticatory muscles. Now, the first of all, masticatory muscles, we perform masseter, we perform like this little bit with fingers, temporalis muscles, and my DVD, if I'm not mistaken, number 8, I full protocol demonstrate. I highly recommend to study this protocol. This protocol was developed at least 26 years ago, and since in massive virtualization working very well. When we're preparing a little bit the masticatory muscles, what we're doing, we're after this asking to open mouth. And that's like 30 degree opening mouth, a little bit more, and I support, you see in this case with the right hand I support, but right now under stretching, masseter allowed me under stretching to mobilize all this belly and all capacity, let's say, of this, of these muscles, and pterygoid lateral muscles also under stretching, much more exposed to my fingers, and of course the temporalis. And temporalis, even I will open a little bit more, I will stretch a little bit more, and even this muscle, not so big mass, and when we're talking on deepness, it's not, but to effective, let's say like this, to mobilize, we have to stretch. And of course the trigger point therapy, we can, under stretching could be discovered and can be compressed much better.
I hope you enjoyed and find this kind of practical and helpful, this approach of utilization of four strategies in order to reach deep tissue mobilization. This fragment is from my DVD number 12. On this DVD, it's two disc DVD, you will find overview on scientific review of trigger point therapy. I do explain trigger point therapy, and mainly this DVD number 12 dedicated to full body deep tissue mobilization. Utilizing these four strategies, I teach step by step how to perform full body deep tissue mobilization, and special this is for clients who would love to feel stronger. There is no doubt that we can satisfy them, and should. If somebody like to feel this stronger, we can. In a frame of format not to activate pain elastic system that I spoke previously, we can. We can send message. Sometimes it's more in head. You see, in this DVD, number 12, I teach you send a message.
Now, if one of your clients will tell, oh, can you a little bit stronger, what you will do, you will apply pressure, you a little bit will move, will stretch, you will come to the close to the origination of quadratus lumbarum, yeah, and a little bit, you in such a case, you can flex slowly a little bit with elbow and compress a little bit against quadratus lumbarum, not otherwise. You can on top also, but when elbow flexed, it's much more effective, and they will feel. Also, not to overdo, guys. Even they just, I call this anger management. If they will try to push you to injure them, don't do this. Slowly, slowly, your clients will come back to you. You will be good. They will feel good, not only at the time of kind of when they try to release anger. This is deep enough techniques.
Apply gradually, not traumatizing. You see, we're in the business of massage therapy, therapy by means of massage. If due to vigorous application of pressure, we traumatize, this is not a massage and not a massage therapy. This is opposite, trauma. Okay, but in the same time, they need this feeling, and I teach just send a message gradually, until activation of pain analyzing system. You see, if there is the experience like pressure in good healing pain, Chinese calling this healing pain, this is okay. It's very acupressure have their own positive effect. It's called activation of piezoelectrical streaming potential. And I do explain what is additional to our narrow reflectorical factor. We'll speak on it. Yeah, later on. It is very positive. Acupressure, we know what acupressure does. Thanks to Russian physician Dr. Dubrovsky, he works in West tremendous amount of work, and he just explained mechanism of acupressure and most of oriental massage physiological effect, how this work. And this is due to streaming potential. I do explain it on my DVD number 12 also.